Guys, we have got a special game for you today.
Yay.
I'm going to close down the splash screen.
Hi.
And get us started. We've got a special game today.
Boy, is it ever.
You're probably wondering, what game could capture the hearts and minds of Octo and Jesse on this wonderful day?
Well, we're about to answer that question.
We're about to tell you right
mm-hmm.
now.
This'll work.
Everything's going to be fine. Everything's going to be fine.
No, Dust.
Alt-Enter. Alt-Enter.
Uh-huh.
Alt-Enter. Alt-Enter.
That's working. It's working. There it is. Hey! There he is. Hey, we did it.
We did it.
Hey, guys. This is Star Trek The Next Generation, a final Unity event.
Captain's log, stardate 47111.1.
It's Patrick Stewart.
A Federation listening post on the Romulan neutral zone has detected an unidentified vessel headed for Federation space. The Enterprise is moving to intercept.
At its reported heading and velocity, the vessel will enter Federation space in approximately 47.3 seconds.
Go to yellow alert.
We have the vessel on sensors.
The ship is a Garidian scout ship. They are driving their engines too hard. Their warp cores are
dripping. Really
the Garidians?
What is the status of their relationship with the Romulan Empire?
They are on friendly terms and may share technology.
We are being hailed.
On screen.
Help us. We are fleeing political persecution. We seek asylum. We are being persecuted.
Their signal is breaking
when
up.
When I first saw this game's graphics,
what do you make of
it
this,
blew
one?
My mind.
Could be a trick.
The Garidians have earned a reputation as honorable warriors, Captain. They do not ordinarily resort
Michael
to trickery.
We are within visual range. The Garidians' warp drive is failing. They are dropping to sublight speed inside Federation space.
Slow to impulse.
Warper deep will be directly ahead.
Okay. Yeah, I think you should honestly just turn it down on the volume.
The Warbird is also Garidian. They are hailing us.
This is an internal Garidian matter. Withdraw at once.
You are violating Federation space.
They have cut off transmission.
This is important. This is all exposition.
The Warbird has locked its tractor beam onto the scout ship.
Go to red alert.
Red alert, we're already... This has not even been 5 minutes and we're already in red alert.
Yeah, we just started and we're already at red alert.
Yeah.
All right, hopefully the sound is fixed. Hopefully everyone's good. Everyone's happy. Uh-oh.
We get the intro. We get the whole intro. No. I'm not talking like just the splash stuff at the beginning.
The final frontier.
I'm talking the credits.
These
are
the voyages of the Starship Enterprise.
Oh, yeah. He does the whole thing.
To boldly go.
Where and seek out new lives and new,
space.
Yeah, okay, here you go.
Oh, Patrick.
Frontier.
Oh, Patrick.
Take it, Patrick. Ooh, listen to that.
These are the voyages of the Starship Enterprise.
Yeah,
its
I know
continuing
the
mission
of the theme.
To explore strange new worlds.
It's continuing,
worlds,
not 5 years. It's continuing mission.
To seek out new life and new civilizations. To boldly go where no one has gone before.
That word art.
Yeah, I'm excited.
Starring Patrick Stewart.
I want to know which one of these celebrities did not show up to be in this.
They all did. I'm serious.
I don't know.
Even,
I don't know that I buy this.
LeVarburg is in. Even Gates McFadden.
Michael Dorn. Oh, my God.
Yes.
Gates McFadden is in this.
That's Dr. Bethany Crusher.
Oh, my God. Diane Troy.
They're all there. Red Spider.
Red Spider. This is before he was killed by the aliens.
Yeah.
Is Guinan in this?
They apparently can't hear anything you're saying. They're missing all these goofs!
There's so many goofs. You guys are missing all the goofs. I feel so bad.
Okay, how about this? Is this still too loud?
No.
I would honestly turn it down to like 30. That's probably fine right there.
Is that fine?
How's this? Is this
Captain's
better?
Log supplemental.
There we go.
A Garidian warbird has violated the neutral zone in pursuit of a scout ship. The fugitives may be seeking political asylum, but as yet we have been unable to confirm their intentions.
Poor Data looks like he got grounded.
Yeah, he's like, I have to sit here because the captain instructed me to.
Look at him, he's so sad.
Yeah, he's that sad Data.
This is pensive, I should be on the holodeck, Riker.
Yeah, okay, the thing I love about this is he's got the lean, right? He's not sitting, he's not in the number two chair.
No, that's
he's got the lean.
He never sat in the number two chair. That never happened. He never he was always standing there, and he was always like,
yeah.
Should I shave or not today? Will the girls on?
Never. And the answer is never,
like
Jonathan Frakes.
Yeah, Jonathan Frakes, without a beard, terrifying.
Mm-hmm.
With a beard, handsomest devil ever.
Yeah.
Ever.
Uh-huh.
Riker's my wingman.
Yeah, absolutely.
To the day I die. Okay. All right. So what do we do?
Well, okay. So this is, I'm going to be honest with you. This is one of those games where you sort of, it doesn't really give you a push.
Why does it like have a slap mark over, that's the tactical screen.
Yeah, that's
the tactical screen. I thought like, what am I?
Talk. Okay.
Troy slap.
So I know how to resolve the situation, but I won't spoil it. I want to see what you do. So you can talk to Data.
Oh, I can talk to Data? Mm-hmm. Do I want to talk to Data?
You can talk to whoever you want.
Comms.
Hold on. I need to talk to Riker.
Astrogation.
If you want.
Computer.
Uh-huh.
Conference lounge. Turbo lift.
I mean, you could just say fuck it and leave if you want to.
I can also go to the view screen, right?
You can, but I believe that all that does
replay conversation.
Yeah, I think if you go to the view screen, all it does is like just show you what's on screen, which is just the Geridian warbird.
Ba-da.
Yeah.
Oh, and they're pulling it in. Okay.
Yeah, they got a tractor beam on it.
Bridge.
You can talk to Troy. What does she think?
Yeah, Counselor Troy, what do you think?
Any insights, Counselor?
I get to click through.
The Geridian captain is torn about something, as if she were faced with a difficult dilemma.
That's Counselor Troy!
The neutral zone.
It's more than that.
Uh-oh.
I think she has a personal stake in this matter.
Uh-oh.
Interesting.
Uh-oh.
Okay.
Mr. Data.
Mr. Data, do you have any suggestions?
As long as the Warbird maintains a track...
It's just
on
them!
Stage,
it's them. It is
just
them.
However, if we maneuvered the Enterprise between the ships, we could temporarily disrupt the tractor beam.
Get out of town.
Get out of here, Data.
Beautiful.
We will have to drop our shields to use the transporter.
Michael Dorn. I will not take that risk. We have to take that risk.
We have
Make
to.
It so, yeah, we have
We're
to.
Bold cap to boldly go.
Right.
Not to timidly go.
Look, I've seen every episode of Next Generation.
Uh-huh.
I know that Picard would take the risk.
Oh, absolutely he would take the risk.
We'll have to take that risk. Make it so.
Oh, FFV! Just so you guys know, our window that we're playing this in is like that big. It's like a tiny, it's like the size of maybe a deck of cards. It is very tiny.
What are we?
We have broken the Geridian's tractor beam.
No, we didn't. It is immediately back on.
Yeah.
It immediately got back on.
The crew
again.
Of the scout ship has been beamed aboard.
Oh, that's why we did that.
Yeah, I was
so distracted by Michael Dorn's voice, I wasn't even paying attention to the plot.
We basically...
Captain,
yeah.
The Warbird is hailing
us. Uh-oh, they mad. Oh, man. Are you ready for some CG aliens?
On screen.
Oh, yeah.
On screen.
Talk to them.
Federation Starship. Who? This is an internal Geridian matter. You've been warned not to interfere.
Okay, I know how to resolve this situation peacefully, but I want you to try. I know the answers that you're supposed to give. So you have to read all of them because they give you a lot. By the way, they're all voice acted. Every single line of this.
Wow, they 100% give you a ton of answers. Okay.
Yes.
Surely we can resolve this matter without recourse. Well, have you violated the neutral zone? You will leave Federation space or face the consequences. You've committed an act of war. Surrender your ship immediately?
That's
Picard
not a very
would never
Picard
say
thing,
that.
Yeah.
Picard would never say that. This, I feel like, is the Picard answer.
Yes. I would agree.
Yeah.
Your presence here gives me every right to interfere. Why have you violated the neutral zone?
Damn right, Picard.
That's
damn
right,
Picard.
That's right.
They're locking their disruptors on.
Oh, shit!
Oh!
Captain, you are harboring dangerous criminals. I demand that you transfer them to my custody immediately.
They're now guests aboard my ship. If you return to Geridian space immediately, I'll overlook the violation. That seems... Whatever crimes they've committed, you have no right to pursue them across the neutral zone. I want to know who these people are and why you have pursued them across the neutral zone. Geridian guests rescued Federation space and extradition diplomatic channels. It's one of these two bottom ones.
It's... Think about the neutral zone.
I do think about the neutral zone. Like, but I also know Jean-Luc Picard.
Yeah, that's true.
I also know Jean-Luc Picard, and I know that Jean-Luc Picard would want to know more information.
That's true. That's true. I'm warning you, if you give the wrong answers, you do have to do a shitty combat sequence. But it's okay. It's easy. It's easy. You can just spam it.
Before this discussion goes any further, I want to know who these people are. Yeah. I want to know that.
Sure, sure.
Before this discussion goes any further, I want to know who these people are and why you have pursued them across the neutral zone.
Damn right, Jean-Luc. Mm-hmm.
They're traitors and killers. My orders are to take them back to Garrod to stand trial for murder and sedition.
Whatever crimes they may have committed, you had no right to pursue them across the neutral zone.
Yup, that's how it works.
I was sent to bring these criminals back dead or alive, and I will carry out my orders means destroying your
ship. That's her mad face.
Oh, I'm squinting at you so hard.
Oh, okay. So now you got a fighter. Mash the both buttons. See that button that says both?
We are being hailed.
Just mash it.
Torpedo lock. The ship is their shields are failing.
Keep pressing it. Fast as you can.
I'm pressing both!
As fast as you can! Keep pressing it!
Oh my god, what is happening to me?
Bad combat is happening.
What is...
Really bad combat.
I'm shooting out my butt, that's good.
We're being hailed.
Hail.
Federation Starship. This is an internal gradient matter. You've been warned not to interfere.
Both.
The ship is...
I think we almost have it.
She's spinning!
Yeah, she's spinning.
She's spinning!
Think about it, there's no real up or down in space. This is about as close as we're gonna get.
The enemy
what is happening is space combat is happening. Hey, Star Citizen, take notes.
Blade shields!
Get us out of here.
Oh shit. You lost the combat. I've never seen that happen.
I didn't lose the combat! We're fine.
You and I are not finished, Picard. I promised you that.
We won the day.
Wait, did we? We don't have enough power. Oh, you gotta keep fighting. They followed you.
Phasers. Everything's set to 100.
The Meridian ship has been destroyed.
Oh, we destroyed it! Woo! We did it!
Alert canceled. Condition green.
Yay!
Okay, damn right.
You go back
to the bridge.
Yeah.
Captain, our new arrivals are requesting to speak with you. Their names are Lucana, Avakar, and Tabak.
I hope those people weren't important that we killed on that ship. Nah. I hope they didn't have families.
Nah.
I hope none of those people had families.
Well, remember, Troy said that she felt personally invested in this crew.
How dare you? How dare you say that to me? Maybe she was invested because they owed her money.
That would be something, wouldn't it?
What are your orders, Captain?
I think we should consider the situation.
Set course. Oh, that's my... Yeah. Consider.
I should like to consider the situation a bit further.
Bit further. Okay, so... If
slap.
You... slap Data on the knee. Good job, Mr. Data!
Good job, slap.
Slap him on the knee.
Slap him right on the ding-dong. Slap his hand. Get off of there! Stop leaning there!
Okay, so... To talk to them, you can click on the door to the left. That's like the
meeting. Oh, so we have to go to our conference room?
Yes.
Oh, okay. T'Bok.
Yeah.
Captain Picard.
Ooh.
Can you help us contact a Vulcan archaeologist named Shaynok? He may possibly hold the key to the discovery of the Lawgiver's fifth scroll.
What the shit?
The fifth scroll? What is this fifth scroll?
What is this fifth scroll you mentioned?
I just want to point out for the record,
uh-huh.
They get all these guys into a studio
uh-huh.
and had them read this gibberish.
Oh, yeah. Well, I mean, you think about it, when they film an episode, it's the same thing. You know, yeah, they get them on the soundstage and they just do the same thing.
At least when they're on the soundstage, they're all acting. Like, this is just them by themselves in a room.
Yeah.
And they're like, okay, you have a bunch of lines, go.
Mm-hmm.
And Jean-Luc Picard was like, yeah.
Yeah.
All right, fifth scroll.
What is this fifth scroll?
Let me give you a bit of background.
Oh, here we go.
Gradian society is a rigid structure consisting of two distinct classes, the patricians and the plebeians.
The patricians and the plebeians?
For the past 1,000 years, that structure has been governed by the laws derived from the four sacred scrolls.
Oh.
The first scroll outlines
a code
of honor.
You made this happen.
The second describes the relationship between the military and the government.
What? You just had to say there's a bunch of scrolls, you don't need to know what they do, but... Religion. No.
And the fourth enumerates the privileges and responsibilities of the patrician class.
But you speak of another scroll.
According to legend, the Lawgiver also wrote a fifth scroll defining the rights and privileges of the plebeian class, which were not explained in the other scrolls.
We're gonna lead a Gradian uprising.
Hmm. What makes you think Shaynok can help? Why are you so interested in this fifth scroll? I think I get that.
I like the last one is, if you'll excuse me, I don't want to talk to you anymore.
Let's do this.
Yeah.
What makes you think Shaynok can help you?
My studies indicate that the followers ended up somewhere in what is now Federation space. But because our governments are not on friendly terms, I could never follow up on that research. But the Vulcan scholar Shaynok lives in the Federation and has made extensive studies of our history. I believe he may have vital information that will help us locate the followers.
I mean, we know why they're so interested, because it'll basically...
Yeah, who's the lawgiver? I probably should know this, though, right?
Yeah.
Who is the lawgiver?
His real name was Avatrunai, and he was the architect of Gridian society. His four scrolls became the cornerstone of our entire culture.
Seems like a huge...
That's all your eggs in one basket.
Yeah, like, okay.
Kind of thing, yeah.
Why are you so interested in this fifth scroll?
I am a scholar, Captain.
Ah,
my interest is purely academic. Lucana, on the other hand, is a social revolutionary. She hopes the scroll will inflame the underclasses to rebellion.
How would an ancient scroll do her any good?
The patrician stopped the lawgiver before he could reveal his fifth scroll. The lawgiver and a few of his disciples, known as the Followers, left Gerrit in five spaceships to start their own.
Oh my god, it's Battlestar Galactica!
Is it? Is that the story of Battlestar Galactica?
Almost. Close enough.
Okay,
sure. And the story gradually took on mythic proportions. The fifth scroll could be the greatest social discovery in Gerrit's history.
The fifth scroll is just like
Sudoku. Even if you don't agree with the goals, I urge you to talk
it's
to
just a bunch of tic-tac-toe games that he
was
playing. Sciences.
And then they spend like 200 years trying to decipher them.
Right.
This could be an intriguing quest.
Yo!
So, the whole thing with this is I like how the Gridians are like Romulans, but not Romulans.
Right, right.
Yeah, yeah.
Can I talk to the others?
Yes, but you just sort of have to resolve this first.
Oh.
I've decided to visit Shaynok.
Really?
What do you think?
Oh, I mean, these two seem like final answers. Mm-hmm. I don't know. Does this one mean that I can come back to him later?
I don't actually know. I haven't played this game in 20 years, but I think.
Oh, man.
I always hate because these old games tend to be a little unforgiving.
All right, fine.
I have decided to visit Shaynok and see whether he can help you regarding the fifth scroll.
Thank you for agreeing to visit Shaynok, Captain. The fifth scroll could be the greatest social discovery in Gerrit's history.
So sad.
I know, sad Brent
Spiner. Chin up, pup. We have another matter to look into. Understood. We'll go under it once. Let's look at this, right?
Yeah.
We have another matter to look into. If you'll excuse me, I have...
Okay,
so now you can talk to... Lucana.
Captain Picard, my name is Lucana. On behalf of the oppressed underclasses of Gerrit, I'd like to thank you for rescuing us.
Mm. Yeah, you're welcome, ma'am.
Don't thank me too quickly. You have illegally entered Federation space, and this ship is not a haven for criminals.
Whoa, he's already bringing the hammer down.
I am not a criminal, Captain. I am only seeking justice for my people.
Very well. You may stay on board the Enterprise until we have sorted this matter out.
Yeah.
Do
Very
not
well.
Dismiss me so quickly, Captain. The fate of all Gerrit is hanging
we
in the
We heard
balance.
From the other guy. Calm down.
Yeah,
Why do you
know.
Say that?
I am searching for the fifth scroll. It's the only way to give the plebeians the freedom they deserve.
Listen, these plebs, they're trying to... Oh, my God.
Who are the plebeians?
Who are they?
Who are the plebeians?
But who are they really?
Yeah, like, tell me about every single one of
one
them.
One of them. I want to know.
Every
names,
last one.
Interests, favorite movie.
Yeah, are any of them single?
Yeah.
Picard is,
that's true.
Yeah, Picard is always eligible.
Yeah.
And always a bachelor.
I think he is the most eligible bachelor on the Starship Enterprise.
Who are
true.
The plebeians?
Well, actually, I think that's probably Data.
Yeah, that's true.
They are the underclasses of Gerrit, forced by law to serve the patricians, their masters, for the past 1,000 years.
1,000 years?
Hmm. I sympathize with your cause. Excuse me, I have other duties. So this is...
Yeah.
We know this. Why are you interested in the scroll? Like, we get that. Okay.
If you'll excuse me.
Sure.
Yeah, okay.
And the last person is...
Avakar.
I feel I should apologize
Whoa!
For my mother's actions, Captain.
I feel I should apologize for my mother's actions, Captain.
Your mother?
Yes. My mother is Pentara, the captain of the Asira. It was her vessel you confronted when she had my scout ship in her tractor
beam. We killed his mom.
Why is your own mother trying to kill you?
She is only doing her duty. I know she doesn't want to kill me, but she is under orders to prevent Lucana from finding the lawgiver's fifth scroll.
Yeah, you're late,
Why are you so interested in this fifth?
Because are we not going to bring this up? Does he not care?
I don't think he knows.
Even though I was born a patrician.
Because remember, he was beaten on board. He can't see what we did.
The fifth scroll would give them a more honorable place in Garidian society.
Then
I
didn't
sympathize with your
if he
course,
didn't see it, didn't
happen. Yeah, we don't have to tell him.
Yeah, if he didn't see it, didn't happen, I'm not going
to
tell him.
We don't have to tell him that it happened.
I don't have to tell him shit.
Yeah.
I don't know him. I don't even know him.
Mm-hmm. We just met him. Literally.
I don't owe him. I don't know him. We just met him.
We just met.
We just met him. He's probably lying anyway.
Yeah, yeah.
Garidian's known liars.
A lot of, you know, I mean, that hair is a very common hair.
Yeah, and he's a pleb, too, so you can't trust him.
Nah, definitely
Yeah, for 1,000 years, no one's trusted a pleb.
Yeah, exactly.
And we are not asking you to do so, Captain. When the time comes, we will fight that battle ourselves.
Ooh. Oh, okay. About that. Okay, well, I guess we've done that. Should I talk to the crew?
Talk?
Counselor Troy.
To Riker.
Counselor, do you have any thoughts?
I'm sorry, Captain, but I don't have any suggestions right now.
Thanks,
you did
Troy.
You did just murder her, Captain.
Yeah, you did kill her.
Riker?
Any suggestions, number one?
I'm sorry, Captain, I don't...
What?
What about Michael Dorf?
Mr. Worf, you're an...
Captain. We should check our orders from
Starfleet. Yeah, I think you're supposed to resume your patrol of the neutral zone now.
Mr. Data, any
I suggest we contact Starfleet.
Oh, yeah, do that. Hmm. Use the computer.
Primary core access enabled.
Oh, wait, okay.
Systems online.
Okay.
Oh, my.
Yeah, there's
a lot
of
Wait, the computer of the Enterprise makes this awesome, like, musical noise in the background?
Yeah, just like whenever you access
Are you telling me whenever Data or Geordi or Wesley or all the other people who died while helming the bridge, this is what they heard when they were like...
Anytime. It's sort of like, it's like when you're on hold with a tech support company.
Oh,
this is what plays while it's looking.
I wonder everyone was very peaceful.
Yeah. Okay, so go to...
Oh, my goodness. It's telling me everything I ever want to know.
Oh, yeah. It has all of the info about the Enterprise here.
Holy moly. Well, that's too much information.
Go back to the bridge.
Some might say too much information.
Put the hand over... the terminal that Riker is leaning on?
Astrogation?
Yeah, I think that's it.
Whoa!
Of course. Yeah, you can literally, like... Yeah. So you can see your solar system.
Oh, this is badonkers.
Yep. So you can see, like, where you are in relation to all the major other cosmic bodies around you.
What the hell is this?
Yeah.
What is this?
Yep.
Space tornadoes?
Yeah, well, those are quasars, I think. Click on one.
Warning. Selected destination is a subspace vortex.
Subspace vortex, sorry. It doesn't let you drive into that. Yeah.
What is this? Buoy. Yeah. Navigational buoy. Okay, so what should I be?
Do course.
Engage. Warp 5.
Display. Oh, God. Okay, go back to bridge for a second. Because I know there's a way you can,
Well, there's astrogation, and then there's...
Riker. Because he says we
tactical
should...
Tactical screen.
Because what we're supposed to do
What about
is...
the turbo lift? Can I go down to engineering and see Geordi?
I think we can. I don't remember. Yeah, engineering.
Transporter holodeck.
I don't remember if we can use...
It doesn't matter if we can... Oh, my God.
Oh, yeah. This just lets you watch the cutscenes.
Oh.
Yeah,
all
right. Yeah.
All right. All these things I missed because I was busy trying to mess with the sound.
Yeah.
If I wanted to watch those, I would.
There's the option.
Yeah.
I don't know.
It's nice that they let you
Look at that little animation of him walking over. He's like, oh, shit, Captain's back on deck.
Oh, Captain's back.
I have to look casual.
All right, what if I go to engineering? Geordi.
Oh, that's just this.
No, Geordi. What?
Yeah, we want him to do that.
Mr. LaForge, you have engineering.
Yes, sir.
Do you think they just hired him to come in and be like, yes, sir.
No, he has whole lines and everything. Like, you can take him on your away team.
There's away teams?
Oh, dude.
Oh, my God.
Jesse.
Oh, my God.
Jesse.
This might be...
You get to pick your away teams.
Can I take the one guy? What's that guy? That everyone hated?
Miles O'Brien?
Not Miles. Everyone loves Miles. Until he left and went to go... He got married and then went on Deep Space Nine. No, I'm talking about the other guy.
Quark.
Not Quark, he's Deep Space Nine too. You know, the guy. The one everyone hated. You know, the guy.
Tasha Yar? She died.
Not Tasha Yar. The guy. You know. Barkley.
Oh,
that's who. Barkley. Yeah.
No, everybody hated him.
Everyone hated Barkley.
No, they figured out my joke. I just named people now. That's, okay. So.
Weapons, shield, other.
Mm-hmm.
Interesting. Okay, I guess back to, can I go to tactical?
Go to red alert.
Oh, that's
my
shields.
Oh, no.
Alert canceled. Condition breach.
Okay, we're fine.
So go to the computer, right?
Mm-hmm.
Primary core access enabled.
Missions.
Systems online.
Good call. Captain's logs. Intercept. Federation listening post along Romulan neutral zone. Enterprise is moving to intercept. A Garidian warbird. Okay, so that's what just happened.
Okay, yeah. Can we go back to missions?
Communiques. Missions.
There's a way you can,
mission
like,
logs.
There's a way you can, like, hail or, like...
Tricorder.
I mean, just go back to bridge.
Analyses. Destinations. Starbases.
I can't remember.
Primary core. Local area. Missions. Culture. Starfleet. Communiques.
Nothing from Starfleet. Here, go back to...
Protect Federation space, provide aid and assistance, gather knowledge, regulate shipping. Oof, we are...
Super fancy. This is all just, like, flavor info.
Small auxiliary craft.
Yeah, you can...
shuttle bays.
They have, like, all that stuff.
Huh?
Yeah, oh, yeah, there's...
Huh? Butler?
What's that? I don't know who that is.
Folk dancing? And drama? Savannah, Georgia? Who is Butler?
I don't know who that is.
Who is Tamara Butler?
I don't know. I've never heard of that person before. Go back to the bridge.
Yes.
Okay. Go to...
comms. Oh, we're so dumb.
Admiral Williams here. Right. What can I do for you, Captain?
What was your assessment of our recent performance?
Yeah, I'd like to confirm our current orders.
I'd like to confirm our current orders.
Of course. Starfleet Command is still considering the options. While we review the situation, the Enterprise is to remain on patrol.
Okay.
Go down.
Particularly we should be aware of?
Yeah.
What is the current situation, Admiral? Is there anything in particular we should be aware of?
Actually, things are relatively quiet right now. The only cause for concern is all the Romulan activity in the area.
Okay.
I think that's it?
Screw it.
What's your assessment of our recent performance?
The Enterprise's presence in this region has set a lot of minds at ease, but I'm still concerned about the Romulan activity in the area. Look sharp, Captain.
Okay.
I think that's it.
Picard out.
Picard out.
Okay, so go to the astrogation. Mm-hmm. And course. That actually sets you.
Stars?
Stars not displayed. Stars displayed.
Yeah, you can
grid
see.
Not displayed.
We have to, like, pick
displayed.
Where we're supposed to go.
So we want to go back to Federation space.
Federation space, not displayed. Federation, Romulan neutral, nebula, non-aligned
space. Oh, we're supposed
space,
to go to the neutral
not
zone.
Displayed.
So display the neutral zone.
Neutral zone displayed.
Okay.
And zoom out. Yeah, there you go.
Ooh.
So just pick something in the neutral zone. Just click on one of those. Turn off Federation space. Or on the right.
Federation space, not displayed.
And just go to it.
Oh, okay, are you sure?
I think so, because they said we're just supposed to,
patrol the neutral zone?
Patrol the neutral zone.
Are we not going to Ragnarok or whatever the hell that place was?
What? Wait.
To find the person?
Wait, should we do that? I don't know if we can do that yet.
Okay.
Here, let's...
Angor Ada.
Let's do it.
Sure.
Do course.
Course set.
Engage.
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 Nice.
So, and they do the whole thing.
Ooh.
Go back to the bridge. So, here's what's kind of dumb is, like, it literally will, like, wait until you get there. And it's, like, timed. It's in real time.
Captain, we are receiving an emergency transmission from Simco 4.
That's all we're supposed to do.
Simco 4? Isn't there a research center there?
Yes, sir.
The work at Merton's orbital station focuses on power generation.
Oh, Merton's, yeah.
The researchers there are among the best in the Federation.
Yeah, Doc Merton's. I love their shoes.
Yeah, they make great orbital space station shoes.
Yeah,
Relay the transmission to Starfleet.
On screen. We have to.
On screen.
Yeah, we're
on screen. This is Captain Jean-Luc Picard of the Federation Starship Enterprise.
That's a
How
look,
can we be
let
a
me tell you.
That guy.
Captain Picard, I am Deneb, Chancellor of Simcoe. We are in need of immediate assistance. Merton's orbital station has been attacked by an unknown vessel and does not answer our hails.
Uh-oh.
Attacked? But the station is a purely scientific facility.
Yeah, but people are assholes, Picard. Like, why don't you...
Yeah. From what he has seen so far, you'd think that he'd be like, oh, yes, of course.
Yes, people are pretty
people
shitty.
People are awful in space.
Yes.
Especially, sir.
Yes, I fought many awful assholes, but he's like, what?
Yeah.
A science facility?
Attacked!
Who would dare?
Yeah.
Is the attacking vessel still present?
We do not know. Whoever or whatever they were, our sensors did not detect them.
Perhaps it was a cloaked Romulan vessel.
But they can't fire while cloaked.
That's true.
I doubt the Romulans would venture this far into Federation territory. The risks are too great.
Captain, you must hurry. The attack has destabilized the station's experimental power core.
That's a big deal.
We don't know how long we have until a core breach. But I can tell you the resulting energy release and radiation would be catastrophic.
What about survivors? Did anyone get off the station?
What? There's one, at least one.
Yeah,
Riker.
One guy.
We detected several escape pods, but we haven't recovered them yet. The pods we detected could hold only a few dozen. There are hundreds aboard the station, including families.
Oof.
Set course for Simcoe 4. I hope it's not too late.
Simcoe 4.
Thank you, Captain. I hope you arrive in time.
Okay, so this game is kind of crazy for the time it came out, because there are actually a couple ways to solve this mission.
We'll
I know
best.
How to do two.
Got out.
A bad one and
Dr.
a good
Crusher.
Oh!
Here we
Crusher
go.
Here.
Gates McFadden!
What up?
Doctor, we may shortly be taking on a large number of wounded, possibly hundreds.
How much time have I got?
Not enough, I'm afraid. Picard out.
Damn.
Well, get ready.
Miss LaForge?
Yes, Captain.
We're en route to Merton's orbital station. They've been attacked, and they're going to need immediate assistance. See what you can find out about their experimental power core.
I'll see what I can dig up, but the Simconians do some advanced work. It may take a while to figure it all out.
Then I suggest you work quickly. Millions of lives on the planet's surface may be at stake.
Uh-oh.
I expect a full analysis of the situation and
How
our
badly
options
can I screw this
as soon
up?
As we're within sensor range.
Woo! Pretty bad.
Yes, sir.
Warning. Entering the neutral zone.
Engage.
Okay, so this automatically
Entering
makes you
Federation
go
space.
Gotcha.
Simcoe 4.
Simcoe 4?
Light years 29.7. Oh, we're cruising.
22.8. We're going warp 7. We are going very fast.
Yeah, warp 7. What's the max before you can overload? I think it's 9.2.
9 point something. I know warp factor 10 is impossible.
Yeah, it's impossible.
You shouldn't do it.
No, just don't. It overloads the dilithium crystals.
Captain
yeah,
Tom,
that's just bad news.
We have arrived at the Simcoe system in response to a distress call regarding Merton's orbital station. The station was apparently
it's like a weapon I found in Diablo 3.
Leaving it in danger of a
that?
Power core.
Yeah,
it kind of does. A lot of those weapons, it's just like, how do you hold this?
We're within sensor range of the Merton's orbital station, sir.
Okay, should we scan?
On screen. Miss LaForge?
LaForge here.
Report, what is the condition of the station?
You're looking at what's left of the Merton's orbital station,
what's
one of the largest research centers in the Federation.
Wow.
The focus of their work is on power generation. 5 years ago, they built the prototype of an experimental power core, and it's been running the station ever since.
Power generation studies?
Oh, he's cute.
Oh, hey, I'm here.
Yeah.
I've been in contact with Starfleet headquarters. Power generation is only part of what this station studies. For several years, researchers
how
here
much
have been working
had to
on new
for
ways
this?
To detect
no,
cloaked vessels.
Incredible.
Yeah, it's pretty amazing.
If the Romulans discovered this, they might have risked a raid. The Simconians did not detect the attacking ship. It may have been cloaked.
Hmm.
That's speculation, Mr. Worf. We have no proof the Romulans were involved.
Don't generalize here,
Worf.
Mr.
Always
Worf.
Talking when he should be shooting.
Listen, Worf.
Well, whoever it was, something powerful punched through the station's shields and sliced off an entire research wing.
Whoa!
What do you mean, sliced off? There is insufficient debris in the area to indicate that the missing section was destroyed. It is possible the attackers simply removed it.
Interesting.
What?
Why? Maybe they wanted what was in there.
Jordy, could that be what destabilized the power core?
No, and that's what I can't figure out. Damage to the upper deck should only cause minor problems, but I'm reading serious power fluctuations. Maybe serious enough to breach the power core's containment field.
What will happen if the containment field fails?
I can't say for certain, but with the amount of energy that thing can put out, I wouldn't want to be around it when it goes.
Yeah, me either,
Jordy. Is there any way to shut down the core?
There's a fail-safe mechanism which is supposed to jettison the core automatically in an emergency.
I'd say this qualifies as an emergency. Why wasn't the core jettisoned?
The only way to prevent it is by manual override. Someone has to be there to stop it.
That means there's someone still alive in there.
Uh-oh.
Data, are you picking up any life signs?
The station's shielding is interfering with our sensors. I cannot tell if any of the crew are still alive. However, life support is still functioning. But power readings indicate that it may fail at any time.
Dr. Crusher?
Crusher here.
We are nearing Merton's station. Are you prepared for casualties?
My staff is ready to do double shifts. We can handle about 330 emergency cases, but we'll have to beam the rest down to Simcoe.
It's actually a lot of people if you think about it.
Yeah.
For a ship, like, even though it's a big ship, that's like a lot of wounded.
What is your recommendation?
We can't do anything from here, but to get an away team aboard...
There we go. We okay, this is the meat and potatoes of the game.
I believe I have a solution. The station's upper shields are badly damaged. If we establish a lock on a transporter on the upper decks, a transporter beam could penetrate the weakened shields.
Nice, Data. That's why I'm sending you over.
Yeah, that's why. I can tell you the way to the shields. Do you want me to tell you? Or do you want to make your own?
Can I just make a suggestion?
Yes.
This is the away team I would send.
Okay.
How many can I send?
Four, and then I think also Picard always has to go. I think.
Oh, Picard always has to go?
I think so.
Oh, well, I would send...
So five, but one is always Picard.
So literally the entire crew is going. Really,
yes.
The entire crew is going.
Well, here's your options. You have Troy, Data, Crusher, Worf, Riker, Geordi.
Yeah, no. This is an easy... What I would choose is one, Data.
Okay.
Two, Geordi.
Uh-huh.
Three, Crusher.
Uh-huh.
Four, Troy. Five, Riker.
Okay.
That's who I would send.
Sure, okay.
Worf and I would stay aboard. Worf and I, Captain Picard, would stay aboard the ship in case shit went down.
Right.
And I'd be like, Worf, blow up the station.
Yeah.
Let's get the hell out of here. I've always loved you, Worf. And that's, yeah. And then they run away
into
together.
The neutral zone.
Yeah. I would send Counselor Troy. You never know if they need a counselor.
I'm really sad you can't bring O'Brien, personally.
O'Brien is the only one operating the transporters.
That's
for many
true.
Seasons, that's all he did was operate
he
the transporter.
He just kind of did this.
Yeah. He would just move his hands up and slowly massage an iPad.
I always wanted to do that. I thought.
Well, now you can.
Yeah.
Now you can. Make it so.
Is there a transporter app that I can just do like the boo?
That's all it does is just go boo.
And then it makes the transporter sound.
Yeah.
Very well, number one.
Make it so. Yeah.
Geordi, I want you and the rest of the away team ready to go in 20 minutes.
Oh, so Geordi's definitely going. See,
Geordi
because he has to go.
Geordi has to go.
And Crusher has to be there. And Data, he's just always on away missions.
Do you want me to tell you who the team you're supposed to send is?
Yes.
Okay. Crusher, Geordi, Riker, Worf.
Really?
Yes.
Crusher, Geordi. I mean, hold on. I thought you said he had to be five.
But, and then Picard.
Okay, so am I going to the turbo lift?
No, it actually might. Yeah, it might actually only be four. I can't remember. It's been 20 years.
Transporter.
Yeah, transporter.
Oh my god!
Oh, I know. Look at this.
Oh
beam
my
down coordinates
god.
Selected.
Oh, it makes it do it by itself.
Oh, I guess this one.
Never
mind. This one, you have to do it. In later missions, you get to choose, but in this one, they make you do it. Okay, here we go. This is the game.
This is the game?
All that other stuff we did, that was just...
Can I select a different person?
Yes. Yeah, if you click, you can select who you want to do what.
What click?
Okay. Yeah. And then you gotta decide where you want to walk to.
All right, I'm gonna walk here. And I'm going to...
So you have talk, you have use, you have look, and you have walk.
Look at power monitor? No, all right. Enough of this.
I would have
Data.
Geordi.
Yeah, Geordi. Come look at this.
All primary subsystems are down. Inertial dampers, life support. No telling how long until these power surges overload the backups. We'd better hurry.
Oof.
I know. That sounds serious, I'm assuming.
Power monitor. What else is there to look at?
I don't think there's much. Oh, that's just...
I don't recommend we send anybody through. With these energy fluctuations, any living matter could be severely distorted.
The fact that every member has a thing to say for everything in this game is crazy.
Look at the transporter panel.
From this console, we can do point-to-point beaming inside the station's shields.
That's important to know.
Good to know, yeah. All right, look at tricorder. Mission objective, stabilize life support. Station is Center for Power Generation Research. We know that too. Okay. What was that?
What they said.
Resume.
Yeah.
And then look at the med kit.
So we got a med kit,
med
we got a tricorder, and we got a phaser.
All right. Let's go to the dock. Let's move her. Walk to door, walk to transporter.
Yeah, the arrow means next area.
Should I just send her by herself?
Oh, they all go. If you go, everybody goes.
What the shit?
Okay, go over to that. The big cable. Send Worf too.
Yeah, I'm sending everybody. It's so good, it's so
look at
tiny.
These, like, tiny little Federation
little
guys.
Little ant people.
I'd sure like to get a look at that power core. Just one of these conduits could handle the entire energy output of the Enterprise.
Wow.
All right, you can keep walking. Okay. He's just so mesmerized, like, oh.
I've got to talk to the engineers who built this place. The entire hull is lined with a liquid tritanium-duranium alloy in a memory gel suspension.
Wow.
It's completely
self-sealing. I think my mattress has that.
You mean the station heals itself?
Pardon?
That's one way to put it. The attack caused major structural damage. If this were any other station in the Federation, we'd be standing in a vacuum.
Wow. Okay, so this is important. There's somebody underneath
there. Oh my god.
This is important.
Medical tricorder.
On trapped woman.
She's got multiple fractures in both legs. The bones in the lower part of her left leg are shattered. She's in shock and there's some internal bleeding. All things considered, she's very lucky. I can take care of the worst of her injuries here, but I'd like to get her to sickbay.
Okay.
So you got the med kit.
It's not working.
Oh, shoot, yeah.
Med kit. On Crusher?
On Crushed Woman.
I can't do anything for her until we get that cable.
Okay.
Okay, so, Worf.
Okay, this is important.
Yes?
So, you see that those colored squares above...
Yes.
There,
yeah.
That's the power of your phaser.
Oh. Okay.
So you want to use that phaser on the cable to cut it.
Uh-huh.
But I have to make sure it's not lethal because otherwise
is red dead or is yellow mellow?
Click on yellow.
Yellow?
That's high setting. Okay, no.
Low setting.
Yeah. I would save first just in case we accidentally kill her.
Saved. And to save. Jesse. Save done. Yep. Saved. Resume.
Okay. So blast that cable with a phaser.
Maybe. Hold on.
It is a data transfer line. It was severed by an energy blast.
This cable's built for handling information, not energy. I'm surprised it didn't just vaporize when it was hit.
Gotcha. Okay, so that's the clue. And then...
Yeah.
The cable has been cut.
Okay,
so she's still alive. So now we have to figure out how to move that cable, right?
Can I just...
It is too heavy.
It's too heavy to move.
Okay, so...
But if you'll remember, when we first came in the room, there was a transporter that said it was used for beaming things throughout the station.
Oh, you goober. Use next room.
That does not work.
What do you mean, that does not work?
So,
walk to the next room.
Yeah, so we basically have to go back and use the transporter to to transport that cable back into the transporter.
Oh. The screen is cut off in this.
Oh, is it?
Yeah, it's a little too big over on that side. So
what?
Just make it a little smaller. You just don't tap, yeah.
What? There.
That should be good.
That should be great.
Okay, so now...
Worf, go in here. Walk to catwalk, walk to passage.
Okay, so now try using the transporter.
Mm-hmm. Use transporter panel. Use lock on?
Yeah, use lock on. Data cable, there we go.
Oh, okay. Energize. And then her legs are just gone.
they were attached.
Oh, God.
They were fractured, so.
The end.
Yeah, that's it of her.
Okay, so we can walk back.
So now we can walk back and go use our med kit on her.
Mm-hmm. All right, everyone, come on.
This is one thing that's a little annoying.
Does it matter? They're all going to show up here, right?
Yes. If you zone out, everybody follows you.
Great.
It's just if you want somebody to interact with something specifically... You have to select them.
Gotcha.
Yeah.
Let's put this down to less lethal.
Yeah, we don't need that right now. Okay, right. So...
Beverly, I need you to...
Use that med kit.
That takes care of the worst of her injuries. She's coming around now.
Can we talk to her?
We can talk to her. Talk to him, Bev.
How do you feel?
I'll manage. You're from Starfleet, aren't you?
Yes. We're from the Enterprise. Try not to move. I've stopped the bleeding and given you something for the pain, but your legs are in bad shape.
You're right. Multiple fractures, probable lacerations. I'm Anna Bennett, Chief Medical Officer.
How ironic.
We've got a lot of wounded here, some worse off than me. How many can you evacuate?
For the record.
Yeah.
The difference between actors from the show
and
voice actors they've hired for this game so far is...
humongous.
Amazing.
Which is actually kind of interesting if you think about it, because, like, if you go back and watch TNG, they're all, like, really good actors.
That's what I'm saying. Yeah. Well, keep in mind that Patrick Stewart is, like, a Shakespearean actor.
Oh, absolutely.
Who somehow got talked into doing Star Trek.
Yeah, I mean, Brent Spiner was on Broadway.
Yeah. They're all, like, really amazing
and
actors.
And LeVar Burton, of course.
Yeah, he was the butterfly in Reading Rainbow.
He was.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Butterfly in the sky.
I can go twice as high. Yeah. Exactly.
Take a look.
Mm-hmm. It's in a book.
It's in a book. Reading Rainbow.
I always said that if I was that a good like
our sick
villain
can
name would be the Reading Rainbow.
Cases. The rest we can beam down to the
sure,
planet.
Like a book theme
supervillain.
But we
super can't villain. Begin transport until we lower the station's shields.
Also, it's not his name. That's one of his moves. If you're a wrestler,
Would be the Reading Painbow.
LeVar
right?
Hurton.
Yeah. Oh.
His ability is
the
Reading
Painbow. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Butterfly in the Sky is the move he does when he jumps off a ladder.
Yeah,
come
yeah.
Come on,
that's
Octo.
That's the moon assault. That's the moon assault he does
on.
Off the turnbuckle. Right.
Reading Painbow. That's Reading his Painbow. Theme song when he comes out, and it's done by Andrew WK. Yep.
Yeah, right. Good. I like it.
We can't do that until we stabilize or jettison the power core.
How many wounded are there?
How many wounded are there?
I can't give you an accurate count, but the first attack destroyed an entire wing. I was headed for sick bay when we were hit again.
Do you know who or what did this?
What?
We never knew what hit us. There was an initial attack which lasted maybe 10 minutes. Later there was a hull breach and the power systems went crazy. I don't remember anything after that.
You're no help.
Uh-oh. What do you mean when the power systems went crazy?
What did you mean when you said the power systems went crazy?
Yeah.
It's this insane experiment Dr. Greems and some of the other researchers put in place.
This is a crazy experiment.
A revolutionary power source. It's unstable enough to begin with. After sustaining damage like this, who knows what it'll do?
We've picked up some rather large power fluctuations. Is that normal?
How should I know?
Those maniacs.
How do I know?
Well,
don't ask me.
Not even like I live here.
They took the biggest research station in the quadrant into a singularity, a black hole.
Uh-oh.
Then why the instability? I thought most singularities were stable. Greems came up with some scheme to increase the energy output. Something about gravity waves. I don't know all
something
the details,
about, what
but
is
it
this
involved
line?
Destabilizing
waves.
The containment field.
Something about gravity waves. We'll get you beamed out of here as soon as possible. Maybe this? How are you feeling? Is there any pain? What happened to the rest of the crew? I can't believe they just left you here. Yeah, like
yeah.
What happened to the rest of the crew? I can't believe they just left you here injured like this.
Nobody likes me. I talk so slow.
Most of them probably escaped when Commander Wilde gave the order to evacuate after the first attack. But I know many are trapped and can't reach the shuttle base.
Uh-oh.
Mm-hmm.
I think...
You're beaming out of here as soon as possible.
Yeah.
I feel like... Yeah, let's do this.
Yeah, I think that's...
We'll get you beamed out of here as soon as possible. Don't try to move. You may aggravate your injuries. Thank you, Doctor. I'm aware of that. I'll stay
put. I'm a doctor too, Doctor.
Yeah, I'm a doctor too, Doctor. Doctor.
Doctor.
Doctor.
Doctor.
We'll be back once we've restored life support and lowered the shields. Wait a minute. Life support is failing? What's wrong with it? It wasn't damaged in the attack.
You know what? She is one line about a sausage away from being in a porn.
Yeah, it's true.
Life support is failing?
Oh, no.
What's wrong?
How do we fix it?
Yeah. Is there a knob I have to blow on?
Do we have to plug anything in? That's not a beach. This is a bathtub. All right.
Main power is fluctuating so wildly that it's disrupting the life support systems. I warned them about using an inherently unstable power source, but I never thought it would come to this. We can probably stabilize life support if we can switch to emergency power. The only place you can do that is in station administration,
okay,
and you'll need the security code to access the emergency systems.
Nice.
It's 334L42.
No, but we can always look at our tricorder again.
Yeah. 334 left 42.
Left for dead 2.
Left for dead 2.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Anytime. Good luck.
You're going to be okay. I guess we'll just leave you here.
Okay. I guess we can walk to the next room?
Yes. We can move on.
Let's get out of here. Crusher strutting our way out of here. So we have, whatever the hell, walked turbo lift.
That's a turbo lift.
Is there anything?
I think that's the only place we can go.
Walk to the conduits. Okay.
I like how it's got that, like, sort of mid to late 90s CG where everything just looks like it's made of plastic.
Yeah.
Yeah. There we go. Administration.
Administration?
Well, because we want to fix the life support.
I guess you're right.
Yeah.
Although engineering feels like, okay, holotable, control panel.
Let's have Geordi do this.
Yeah.
This feels like a Geordi situation.
It's dead. Power surges have disabled most of the station's primary systems. Looks like a power surge knocked out the holotable. I could fix it if we had more time, or if I had a flux router, I could bypass the damage completely.
Interesting.
Flux router. We should keep an eye out for one of those.
Capacitor.
A lot of these systems are out. I think we're in luck. This life support console's still active.
We want to fix that. All right, Geordi.
Do your magic. Oh, puzzle time.
Puzzle time.
Yo, sweet. Okay. Use emergency systems, yeah?
Enter authorization code. Access granted. Emergency override controls active.
Use power redirect.
Use power redirect. Life support systems disconnected from main power. Operating emergency power only. Life support
is stable at minimum levels. Can I mess with any of this?
I think you can.
How would one do that?
Okay.
What?
Click on the top button again.
Okay.
So what do we want to do here?
Give me that glowy hand. Give me the glow. There's exit. Emergency override controls active. You shut down? I don't want to do that, right?
No, I don't think so. Trick here is.
Hmm.
Life support disconnected from main power. Operating on emergency power only. Life support is stable at
minimum levels. What if I shut down?
I think that just stops.
Will be uninhabitable in 15 minutes? Restoring life support. Okay.
Oh, there we go. Okay, I think we did it.
Did we?
I don't remember. Okay, we'll go down to engineering.
I hope the controls we need aren't in one of the damaged.
Go down to engineering.
Yeah.
Unless there's another door you can go through here.
Not that I'm aware of.
No. Go to engineering, yeah. What the heck is that
Amazing thing? It's using a plasma suspension beam to draw energy straight out of the main conduits.
What in the heck?
What is it?
We should check our tricorder.
Amazing.
Okay. Use tricorder on this? Unknown. Composition, a bunch of minerals and stuff.
Unidentifiable compounds, less than 1% of gold, iridium, hydrogen, sodium,
energy, none. Analysis subject is naturally occurring interplanetary debris.
Huh. That doesn't seem right.
It's... Wait a minute. I had readings of neutronium hull and internal energy, but now all I can pick up are natural elements. It's sending false readings to our tricorders. It's like a chameleon. It disguises itself perfectly. If we weren't here to see it, we'd never know it was here. It could probably fool our ship sensors just as easily. This chameleon field seems to take a fraction of a second to adjust to new scanning frequencies. If I set the tricorder to randomly shift frequencies at high speed...
Yo, Star Trek... technology.
I'm getting a partial reading now.
Okay, surface is neutronium. Minimum thickness, deeper scan, impossible.
Maximum output...
9.6 warp equivalence, duration 10 minutes, reserves increasing, plasma, suspension beam, active scanner waves, phaser capability, subject is warp capable device, origin unknown.
It's that small and it's warp capable.
Yep, it's a neutronium hull, all right, and a powerful energy source. I've never seen that much power in such a small package before.
Oh, Jordy.
Okay, so...
Oh, Jordy.
We're gonna head... Look at where you can walk to.
Engineering lab 4, core control room.
Go to engineering lab 4.
Yeah. Everyone has the best strut.
Right? They're all just walking around. Okay.
You can't tell by the...
Okay. Use my walk. Okay, so... Look for a... What was it?
Wave converter.
It didn't work.
What? Get wave converter.
Yeah.
Yo.
Wave converter.
Graviton probe.
Pulse negator.
I'm just gonna get it all.
Yeah, get it all. Grab all of it.
Plasma shunt.
Flux router. That's what we needed.
Yeah. Oh my goodness. Grab that. We got so much stuff.
Wait, did you grab the flux router?
Yeah. Hell yeah.
We have to get past that machine out there. It's blocking the way to primary engineering.
Primary engineering.
Ideas.
We do not have sufficient weaponry to destroy the intruder.
Thanks, Worf.
What is it doing here?
It appeared to be drawing plasma from the third
conduit. While they're talking, Jordy just robbed this place blind.
Yeah, well, he's taking all of it.
It's collecting energy. Maybe if we can temporarily shut off the power, it'll leave.
Make it think the wells run dry, eh?
Mm.
It's worth a try.
There should be emergency shutoff controls around here somewhere.
Okay, so important thing first, go... did you get that, what was it, flux router or whatever?
I have pulse, graviton wave, plasma shunt, flux router.
Okay. Go back up to...
Inverter coupling.
Go back up to administration. Because remember Jordy said he could fix that hollow table if he had a flux router? We can do that. We have the capability.
Okay. I just was looking around. You're right. Let's get out of here.
Yeah. We'll come back to this in a minute.
Hey, Bev. How's it going?
Yeah.
It's me, Jordy LaForge.
Hey, what's happening? Administration. Okay, we gotta use that flux capacitor.
Okay, use flux capacitor. What was it?
Flux router on the table.
Oh,
hey, look at that. Okay.
There we go.
Look at this damage report. Only a few very specific sections were hit. No random damage at all. This wasn't an attack. This was surgery.
Space surgery.
Cosmic surgery.
Look at this damage report.
Oh, okay. And the hologram and the damage report say the exact same thing, huh?
Yes, I believe so. I feel like we haven't solved the life support puzzle.
Yeah.
I think we're in luck.
Okay. I just feel like it wouldn't let us touch anything.
Yeah.
Graviton.
Can you tricord probe? Scan anything?
Maybe.
No.
With the emergency system's access code, we can shut down or redirect power to life support.
Oh, you know, you might have to get the thing to leave first, because it's messing with the power.
Right. I thought it was supposed to, if we did this, if we shut it down, and we did this, he would, like, stop. But that's it turns back on. It's like,
yeah,
hey, we're good.
Yeah.
Which I feel like if we could change the settings and, like, how stuff works, but...
Okay, well, let's go...
Let me just, hold on.
Pulse negators are used for canceling fluctuations in pulsed energy systems. A graviton probe, that could be useful when you're dealing with a gravitic power source. A wave reduction converter. We might be able to use this. It's a specialized tool for dampening graviton flux waves.
Oh, graviton flux waves.
Right. As everyone knows.
That's a phase inverter coupling. It's for reconnecting multi-phase energy channels and correcting flux modulation problems.
Okay, so...
I don't think we'll need this plasma shunt. The main power source here is definitely not plasma-based.
Okay, so go...
One quick question.
Sure.
Can I hook this to anything?
Try...
Use inverter coupling on exit.
Nope.
I can't make it work.
Is it one of those try everything on everything things?
Maybe.
Try.
I can't make it work with that.
Try the spiky one.
The old spike boy?
Yeah, the old spike boy.
I can't make it.
Nah, nope. Can't make it work with that.
You can't make it work with that. All right, let's exit the exit. All right, maybe we go back down. Use window. Lookout window.
I don't see anything special about it.
Well, I don't see anything special about you, LeFar. Just dead. Kidding, I didn't mean that.
Power surges have disabled most of the station's primary systems.
Okay.
I think it maybe head back down to engineering.
A lot of these systems are out.
Yeah, I guess. Walk to Wharf. Walk to hologram. Walk to...
Come to Wharf.
Security panel. Walk to Crusher. Walk to... Is the hologram just in the way of me being able to go to the...
Try using the holo table. We can turn it off or something. There we go.
Ah, yes. Of course. Turbo lift.
Okay, so we need to figure out a way to...
Well, there was stuff in this room over here. There was a panel that we could access.
That's right.
That I feel like is going to be something.
Well, it's a little unfamiliar, but I think I can control the station's power flow from this panel.
All right, try that.
Good, my dude, good. Okay, so we're back at one of these damn things. Initiate temporary shutdown. Literally, I can just press it. Will that do it?
Maybe, can you press those? Oh, shut down
there
group
we go.
One. Okay, but remember the third cluster.
What do you mean?
So they said he was drawing power from the third cluster. So hold your thing over this.
Shut down group three?
Yeah. And then initiate shutdown.
I think that did it, I think.
Maybe. Ah, there he goes. He's peacing out.
Goodbye, little dude. Goodbye.
Okay, so he's outie.
I'm really curious how that first encounter affects
Before
the rest
Enterprise,
of the story.
Did you pick that up?
We have detected a small object departing the station at high speed. Sensors identify it as a small asteroid.
No, it wasn't.
No, it
you
ain't.
Gotta be kidding.
Apparently,
I assure you, I'm not.
Capable of sending false readings to our sensors.
That asteroid is a sophisticated device. It's using a chameleon field to send false readings to the sensors.
Interesting. The object has accelerated to warp speed.
All right, let's track it down. Emergency transport.
No.
I like to chase it down. The station isn't stable yet.
We haven't.
Yeah.
Yeah. We haven't. fix the station.
I'd like to chase it down, but the station isn't stable yet. See how long you can track it.
Just leave those people out?
So now that we've done that...
We can go across the way, right?
Well, before we do that...
Yeah?
Let's go up to administration and activate life support, because that's the important thing. Because life support...
But isn't life support on?
It's like emergency life support.
Didn't we do it, though?
Try pressing that, and then redirect power.
On this?
Yes. Life support disconnect from main power, operating on emergency power only. Life support is stable at minimum levels. I could have sworn we're supposed to do something with
this. I think we need to, because the power core, we need to just, like, peace out at the moment.
Okay. Yeah, we got to fix the power core.
Yeah.
We do not want to jettison it.
No. What?
No.
You crazy?
Yeah. Because they're like, we can jettison it, but that'll fuck everything up.
You have an uncanny sense of timing.
Hey.
And I beg your pardon?
Timing, I said. You have fine timing.
Timing, I said. Timing.
I cannot afford to be distracted. And in barges all of Starfleet.
Okay,
so talk to him with Jory, because this man's an engineer.
Oh, it's Dr.
I'm Jordy LaForge, chief engineer of the Enterprise. We're here to help.
Thanks for the offer, but I haven't time to instruct Starfleet in the intricacies of single-driven power generation. So kindly stop distracting me.
Starfleet!
Listen, don't distract me.
Large machine, some kind of power conduit.
It's my job to work miracles.
Yeah.
I say yeah.
Dr. Greems, I'm chief engineer on a galaxy-class starship.
Shit, wrecked space station, guy.
Have you seen a system like this before?
Well...
I'm not sure. It looks like some kind of gravity wave power source. But how can you generate gravity waves of this magnitude?
A little something I got from the Romulans. We've got an artificial singularity bottled up down there, and by varying the strength of the containment field, I was able to increase the magnitude of the gravity waves.
Yes!
Gravity waves!
I'm definitely not going to become Dr. Octopus!
But now that something's got the energy flow out of phase with the containment field, we've got to get the energy flow back in phase immediately.
That was a good acting choice.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Not bad for a Starfleet officer.
What's
Why did you say it like Starfleet officer? Starfleet officer?
You may be of some use after all. You see, the only reason the field's held up this long is because I've been here manually compensating for the fluctuations.
Sounds like you could use an extra pair of hands.
Yeah.
Sounds like you could use an extra pair of hands. Listen, I'll handle the conduit. You maintain the containment field.
I'll keep the containment field up as long as I can. I see you already have a phase inverter and a wave reduction converter.
Good.
You'll need them.
Phase inverter and wave reduction converter.
A phase inverter? But that'll just make the fluctuations reverse. Unless...
Oh!
If we use the wave reduction converter to dampen them, the reversal will actually work in our favor.
Oh!
Nailed it, Jordy.
Better than you look. Install the phase inverter coupling in the damaged area. Then use the wave reduction converter to bring the fluctuations down. If I can keep the containment field up, we should make it.
Great.
I'm on my way.
Okay. He's on his way.
So all we gotta do is go to the damaged power coupling. The conduit, sorry.
Watch the control panel. Control panel. Does it matter which one?
The control panel over there lets you jettison the core.
Here?
Yes, that's the one that lets you jettison it.
A lot of these systems are out.
Oh, that one. Yeah.
Use Dr. Grum.
Use him for your own needs.
Maybe just use this one?
That's the one to jettison the core, I know for a fact.
But maybe we have
a lot of these systems are out.
Oh, that one's out.
Okay.
A lot of these systems...
Am I going back to the other room?
Yeah, you're going... So you gotta fix the conduit. Because it's back in the other room. Because it's got the hole in it, right? It's got a little hole there.
Here. Walk to the conduit.
So you gotta use the... Oh, God.
Inverter coupling.
I think it was the inverter.
Inverter.
The inverter and then the wave converter. Oh, I see. I remember the perspective on this is all messed up. I thought it was hanging over.
Oh, it's like
over.
In the back. Yeah, it's way back there. Yeah.
And then,
okay, and then I have to use the...
Wave converter, I believe.
Wave converter.
I can't make it work with...
What?
Oh, I think you gotta use it on the hole. No, on the hole in the power conduit. The hole. It's one of those.
Enterprise.
Picard here.
We've stabilized the power core. The outer shield should be lowered now.
Hey.
Confirmed. We'll start evacuating the wounded immediately.
Nice.
Great. That means we're done here. Beam us up.
We did it!
Oh, so really, the power, like, the life support and everything was fine. We were just trying to work on that for whatever the hell reason.
Yeah.
Cool.
Acknowledged.
Yeah. Acknowledged. We got out. Like, bye!
We were like, peace. And also, that dude is still
we
in there.
We are being hailed, sir. It is Chancellor Danub.
Ah, Danub.
Chancellor.
Danub.
I like how he said that. Fighter of the
Fighter
Night.
Fighter of the Night. Nub. Yeah.
Ah,
champion Danub of the Sun.
On screen.
Ah.
Captain Picard, you have my warmest
this
thanks.
Is,
this
we
guy.
This really is. This hope. Is Danub.
Listen, Danub, I commend him for committing to a look. He just really went for it, you know?
No, you're telling me no one said to him, maybe don't have dreads if you're going bald. No one was like, dude, just accept your balding gracefully.
Listen.
And shave it or something. Or like have a little monk halo. But don't do dreads.
But listen.
Or wear a hat.
But listen. So, Danub, he's not hurting anyone, right? He's living his
Danub.
Best life. He's,
yeah.
Listen, he's just trying his best. Listen, this man is thanking. Listen, you have my warmest thanks. Danub is here giving us his warmest thanks, and you're harping on this poor guy for his hairstyle. I mean, it is terrible, but still.
We're pleased to have been able to help. Have you recovered all the pods yet?
My staff tells me all the evacuees are safe and
Yo,
sound.
Yo, we did that.
And
did
my
it.
Compliments to your medical staff. Our surgeons were quite impressed with Dr. Crusher's handiwork.
What
damn
can
right.
We say?
I'll pass that along. The last of the injured personnel should be beamed down within the hour.
I think we can handle it from here. By the way, Dr. Greems personally extends his gratitude.
How about that?
He felt he owed you and your crew an apology.
That's right, he fucking does.
Tell him we accept his apology.
I like the little ellipses there.
The ellipses there.
Tell him
we accept his apology.
But your hair is terrifying.
It's awful.
Really, are those tentacles, or is that really your hair?
Yeah.
Is it part of your brain?
I mean, I guess if that's like a thing of his species.
Human?
I don't think he's
this
human.
This obvious human?
You think it's human?
Just because his name is Danub doesn't mean...
There are a lot of species in Star Trek.
No, this is clearly a human.
You think that's just a normal-ass
this
human?
This is clearly a normal-ass human with terrible hair.
Okay.
Yeah.
Fair. No, it's fine.
Yeah, he just thought he could get away with it because his name was Danub and no one would question
yeah,
it.
Yeah, nobody, he's just like, my name is Danub. Oh, and what's, and where are you from?
Earth? Detroit?
Yeah, Detroit?
Minneapolis?
Earth?
Picard out.
Picard out.
Oh, he's just like, peace.
Audi 5000.
What are your orders, Captain?
Let's
set course.
Let's continue our patrol of the neutral zone.
Is this game just all about like being cool in the neutral zone?
Yes. Until cool. things
set
happen.
Course
to
for the
you.
Ruin
Which is basically if you think about it.
Along the
Star Trek.
Zone.
What the show
it's
was
exactly
about.
What Star Trek is.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Engage.
Engage.
Engage. We did like we just Tokyo drifted. We just were like,
whoa. Yeah. Man, we banged out that first mission real fast. Okay, go back to the bridge, first of all.
Can I talk to people?
You can.
Counselor, do you have any thoughts?
I'm sorry, Captain, but I don't have any suggestions.
I'm sorry,
right
Captain,
now.
But
thanks,
I'm rather
Troy.
Useless.
Yeah.
But my mother's coming on board one. This episode, so get ready for wild antics.
I'm sorry, Captain, I don't.
Mr. Worf, your analysis.
Captain, we should.
Mr. Data, any suggestions?
I suggest we.
Oh, let's contact Starfleet.
Comms.
Oh, we can just
Admiral
call Danub.
What can I do for you, Captain?
Yo, Danub, what up?
What up?
Anything? Yeah, what's your
What is
of?
The current situation?
Actually, things are relatively quiet right
uh-huh.
now.
Okay. How did I do?
Yeah.
What's your
oh,
assessment
you
of our
good,
recent performance?
Review here.
The Enterprise responded to a distress call from Merton Station. Good work there, Picard. Without your efforts, this could have been a real catastrophe.
That's right.
You saved hundreds of lives, kept the station operational,
and even
managed to save the experimental power core.
They made Kirk an admiral, and that dude
They made Riker an admiral.
He caused so much more trouble.
They made Riker an admiral. That poonhound, they made him an admiral. Can you believe that?
Was any of that real, though?
Yes! Well, no, wait. Was
any of that real, or was that on a holodeck?
No, that was real. That was the last episode. It's when
But are you sure that was the real thing?
It was the thing where he goes, where Jordan
Are you
goes
sure
to
that
visit.
Was the real?
Yes, it's where he goes to visit him on the vineyard, and he's like, we gotta go back, and then...
But are you sure that's real, though? Are you sure that wasn't also on the holodeck?
I don't
What
remember.
Do we? What do we know from... Trying to make sense of Enterprise.
I remember the pool of tar ate Tasha Yar.
I do remember Tasha Yar got eaten.
And then Data banged her.
Data did bang her.
Yeah.
Can I tell you my favorite episode of Star Trek?
Hit me.
It's not my favorite, but it's my favorite bad episode.
Okay, hit me.
The A plot is Data trying to go on a date with a woman who wants to know if he will go out like if, like, he can bang, basically. And he's like, oh, yes, I've done it before. And she's like, when's the last time? And he's like, very long time ago.
Yeah.
Right? But the B plot is people literally falling through the Enterprise.
Wait, that's the A plot?
The A plot is Data, like, trying to get laid and this woman being like, I don't know. The B plot is literally them people getting sucked into the walls of the Enterprise and dying there. It's such a crazy episode.
I remember the episode where Riker keeps getting abducted at night and he keeps getting put into subspace and like he finds out that like other people have been having the same dream as him and he's like there's this really freaky scene where they're like they're in the holodeck and they're like and he's like there's a table but it's an incline but it's made of metal. And so, like, the holodeck is, like, making this, like, surgical table. And he's like, and there's people around. And they, like, make this scene. And he's like, and they're whispering. And he's like, no, it's clicks. They're clicking. And then they're, like, all standing in the holodeck. And they're all like, we've been here before. Boom, cut to commercial. That's a good-ass episode. Does anybody remember the name of that
episode? I also remember the episode where they ate, was it Counselor Troy or Data someone?
They ate Counselor Troy?
Remember that where she was, like, a cake? It was the last season where Data has that dream about the Raven. Do you remember that? Where Data literally starts going crazy and he starts dreaming. And one of the dreams is they're like eating a cake version of someone. It might have been Data. It might have been Troy. Maybe Troy was laughing at Data. And she's like, ha, 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 eating the cake. It was one of those weird insanity episodes.
That's so weird. I don't remember that.
Yes. Huh. See? Told you.
The Troy cake episode was Phantasm. Huh.
Shall I go on?
No, thank you.
Please do. The Enterprise's presence in this region
Okay. All right. Picard out. Question. Oh, that's not what I wanted. Bridge.
Okay, we're cruising.
Thank you again for your efforts.
Dana, how are you
doing?
I'm
afraid we're rather busy. I understand, chap.
I like how you can just call up Dana, but anytime he's like...
Data, give me a scan of this
sector. We're here.
Scanning. Sensors report no unusual activity, sir. All spatial parameters appear to be normal.
Great.
What are your orders, Captain?
I should like to consider the situation a bit further.
Okay.
It seems too normal.
I think you can talk to the people in the comm.
T-Bag?
Yeah, let's talk to T-Bag.
No, T-Bag.
The fifth scroll could be the greatest
discovery
in
its history.
Understood. Maybe we should just go underway at once?
Yeah, let's do it. Fuck it.
Understood. We will be underway at once. I will let you know when we arrive.
Is this like our main quest, and that we just went on a side quest?
Mr. Worf, inform Starfleet that we will be assisting the Garidians in their search.
Aye, sir.
Computer, what are the current whereabouts of the Vulcan archaeologist Shaynok?
According to Federation Archaeological Survey records, Shaynok is currently excavating ruins on the planet Horst 3.
Set course for Horst 3, Warp 5.
Warp 5. Aye, sir.
We're not even in a hurry.
Nah.
Warp 5.
We're cruising.
Engage.
Yeah. Is this voiced by the actual actors? It is. This is entirely voiced by the real cast.
Yeah, this is the actual cast.
Mm-hmm.
This is great.
Mm-hmm.
All All right.
So we're 41 light years away. That's not that far.
We have plenty of bridge time.
Yeah, we got.
Let's
go.
Any suggestions, number one?
I'm sorry, Captain. I don't have any suggestions.
You, number one, you're just. He's like, the only suggestion I have is we go to the holodeck and
Mr. Worf,
bang some holo ladies.
Captain, we should check our orders.
Oh, my God. Riker.
Counselor, do you have any.
I'm sorry, Captain.
You're all useless. Useless, useless, useless.
The only one I can talk to is myself.
Hello, me.
Hello, me. I'm great. Why am I the best captain of
Why
the Enterprise?
Why don't we just bump it up to warp 9?
I think
get
you actually can do that.
We can?
Yeah, go to the,
We're almost there now.
Yeah, I mean, at
we're
this
only 22
point,
light years
it
away.
Makes sense.
Yeah. I wonder how being in space this long affects them.
That's a good question. Because I know if you're in space for a long time, like, when you get back to Earth, can't you, like, not move? Oh, but they got
artificial
gravity.
Well, your bones, like, the bone density decreases. Your bone density decreases a
yeah,
lot.
Yeah. There's some, like, there's some
And there's, like, radiation
stuff.
Issues in it. They say it might change your DNA.
What?
Yeah, they say it, like,
Is that how the Fantastic Four got formed? It is.
It
they
pretty
got
much is.
They got bombarded by cosmic rays.
Yeah.
We need to check out those astronauts, see if they're superheroes.
Everyone knows about
I mean,
space
are.
Madness.
Yeah.
Oh.
Helm. Standard orbit.
He turned to him like, shouldn't you be doing something, number one?
Yeah.
View screen.
Can we... Wait. Talk to... What's...
T-back?
Yeah.
Thank you for agreeing to visit Shaynock, Captain.
Okay, yeah. That's it, huh? What about Lucana?
Thank you for agreeing...
Yeah. What do you want to bet?
Thank you, Captain.
Yeah.
Well, I'm very excited to be here. Okay,
Maybe talk to...
Any suggestions?
I'm sorry, Captain.
Ugh.
Talk to Data.
Mr. Data, I suggest we...
Okay. Can we beam down?
Try
find
it.
This guy?
I know that's... Go to transporter.
There are no valid beam down coordinates
okay.
at this
what?
Location.
The answer is...
There are no valid beam down coordinates at this location.
Computer, astrogation comms. Maybe we can contact Shaynock.
Shaynock.
Greetings, Shaynock.
Whoa.
Oh,
I'm
my
Captain
God.
Jean-Luc Picard. Captain, how may I assist you?
Look at that lip sync.
What was that?
Captain.
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 How may I assist you?
How may I assist you?
Hello, Captain. What brings an archaeologist of your stature to such a remote planet? Several Garidian refugees aboard. Fifth scroll that said you might be able to help. Let's
yeah, let's
here.
Pawn. Let's pawn these motherfuckers off on him. Oh well, let's introduce. Let's
yeah.
yeah, let's get his.
What
first.
Brings an archaeologist of your stature to such a remote planet?
I am excavating the ruins of a Chodak outpost. The
Chodak.
Federation Archaeological Survey is sponsoring my work.
Who are the Chodak?
That's interesting.
Phone Google a Chodak. What's a Chodak?
What is a Chodak?
Yeah.
I wonder.
Who are the Chodak?
Oh, never mind.
An ancient race. At their peak, the Chodak occupied most of what is now the Romulan Empire. But I thought all known
apparently
Chodak,
the Chodak
ruins
are
were on the other
ancient
side of
race.
The neutral zone.
Oh, the, yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Wow, you researched really fast.
Et cetera, et cetera.
This is the first Chodak site found in Federation space. It was my good fortune to discover it.
His mouth, man.
Yeah.
What have you found so far? I'd be most eager. I can beam down immediately, Shaynock. Should we reveal that yet?
We should say, hey, we got these assholes that have been freeloading on our ship for a while. Can
yeah.
you?
What have you found so far?
What have you found so far?
A great deal, actually.
Ooh.
I have uncovered evidence of an extensive administrative system, as well as examples of Chodak computer technology quite similar to our own isolinear rods.
Oh, yes. Mm.
Intriguing. Such devices would be among the oldest known examples of isolinear technology in the galaxy.
Oh, we gotta bring Data on this mission.
Oh, yeah.
I hope to confirm that fact. I sent several rods to the Merton's orbital station for testing.
Ooh.
They've developed a gravitic stress dating method, which is extremely accurate.
Oh.
However, I have not yet received their results.
So they sent it to the Merton's orbital station.
Can I tell you something? Can
yeah,
I tell you something?
Uh-huh.
Can I tell you something?
Yeah, hit me.
The Chodak is still around.
Wouldn't that be something?
The Chodak are still around.
Wouldn't that be crazy?
Don't look at me like that. The
Jesse,
Chodak are around.
No, that's impossible. They went extinct millions of years
ago. No, the Chodak are still around. No. And the Chodak, or the Chodak are all dead, but their machines are still around. And the Chodak, oh my God, they came back for their stuff. Oh.
Interesting. You know, they said they cut off some specific sections.
They came back for their stuff.
Mm.
Oh my God. I cracked it open, Picard. I got it. I got it. Attacked. Almost completely destroyed. Yeah.
I'm afraid we have got some bad news for you, Shaynock. Merton's station has been attacked. It was almost completely destroyed.
Indeed. That is a great loss.
Should we drop this on them now?
I mean, we gotta be like, look. Can you guys take these guys off our hands? They want some piece of paper.
We have several Garidian refugees.
I don't want to talk to you about this, but
find something.
There are some assholes aboard the ship, and it's just a pain in the ass. And I
have to talk about them.
Possibly. I once did extensive research on the Lawgiver and the followers. They fled into what is now Federation space 1,000 years ago, bearing the fifth scroll with them.
1,000 years ago would make it 19... No, that wouldn't make it 19. It would make it 1324 or something
when does,
like that.
When does this take place? 2300?
23-something, yeah. So 13 in the 14th century. I don't know why I thought 19.
Yeah.
In the 13th, no, yeah.
Nostradamus was like, the lawgiver something. Will appear with the
yeah,
fifth scroll.
Yeah, the lawgiver.
Like, yeah, he's like, who's
yeah.
this
We've
guy?
Heard of them. So where did these followers go?
Earth. I never found the followers' colony, but your friends should not lose hope. In my search, I stumbled on one of the followers' ancient ships. The logs indicated that they had found an M-class
Earth.
Planet.
It's Earth. It's
going to
be Earth. It's
going to
be Earth. It's going to be Earth. Even though the 1300s really aren't that long.
No.
But what if they killed the original inhabitants of Earth and all humans?
What if we're Garidians?
Oh my God. We're Garidians.
Ancient aliens.
Oh my God. It
aliens.
Makes perfect sense now. Mm-hmm. There was no... No, there was no record in the 1300s. There weren't no one. People were dumb.
Yeah, nobody
then.
Was writing anything.
Yeah,
down.
No one was writing anything.
Yeah, exactly.
No one wrote a thing.
Yeah. No, it's nobody.
Nobody.
Everybody just told you what they wanted you to
right,
know.
Right, right, right. That hence
you just had
the
to
Dark
remember.
Ages,
yeah,
the Middle Ages.
You just had to remember it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And then immediately afterwards, Renaissance.
That's true.
Think about it.
Oh,
think about it.
Oh my God! It makes
think
sense.
It makes perfect sense. And as we all know, everyone knew Leonardo da Vinci. Huge pointy ears.
Leonardo DiCaprio, big pointy ears.
Yeah, Leonardo DiCaprio, massive ears.
Yeah, mm-hmm.
Huge ears.
Very true. Could be an alien.
Yeah, anyone named Leonardo?
Leonardo Ninja Turtle? Look
oh
at
my god,
green?
Either. Yeah.
Yeah?
Oh my god, mm-hmm. all of them. We yep. cracked it. We cracked
yep,
it.
That's it.
Call us aliens. We need the aliens guy.
Alien Buster.
What's his name? Stevianopoulos?
Stevie Wonder.
Stevie Wonder. Call us Stevie Wonder.
Yeah.
We know what's up.
Uh huh.
Thank you. Can I go down?
Well, you should ask.
I'd be most eager to examine the
I
site
love
myself.
Archaeology.
I can I beam am. Down immediately.
Captain, I'm aware of your reputation as an archaeologist, but I cannot...
Don't
Thank
care.
You for your help, Shaynock.
I didn't know...
And to you, Captain.
Does he have... Does
Live
Picard
long
have, like,
and
training in archaeology?
Yeah, that's, like, his thing.
I didn't know that.
Yeah, he's
I thought
a
he was, like, a... What do you call it? A anthropologist.
I mean, he could be both.
I guess that's... What you, I guess
you're
not
in the future,
exclusive.
What are you going to do? Yeah. That stuff also, more importantly, Picard's that guy who every time there was a problem, especially if there was like a villain, he'd be like, ah, yes. He was a student of history.
Yeah, yeah,
so
yeah.
He'd always tell you, he'd be like, ah, yes, like Genghis Khan and Hitler and,
Kim Kardashian.
Not Kim Kardashian. I just literally...
Not to compare them, but...
And, no, yeah, he'd be like Genghis Khan and Hitler and Khan from... Original,
from
Star,
original
Trek.
Star Trek.
And then he'd say something
Ricardo
like...
Ricardo Montalban.
Yeah.
yeah.
And then he'd
yeah.
say something like, and Gorboth the Slayer. Yeah. You're like, well, of course, Gorboth
the
Slayer.
Gorboth
the
Slayer.
Everyone knows Gorboth the
yeah,
Slayer.
Yeah, yeah, right.
I don't know why I couldn't, even though I said Genghis Khan, I couldn't think of Khan. I was like, what's that guy's name? You know.
Khan.
The other Khan.
The
yeah,
other Khan.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Khan. Yeah. He did the Live Long and Prosper
orders,
thing.
Captain?
What are your orders?
I should like to consider the situation
okay,
a bit further.
So we should talk to our Garidian guests.
Yes, we should.
Be like, listen, I got some bad news
Yo,
for T-Bot. You, T-Bot. Yeah, okay.
What? We're not gonna...
Too long have we been the slaves of our patrician master.
We need your help. Okay.
Please, Captain. In the...
Okay. Can I... Data, talk
Mr. Data, any suggestion?
I suggest we...
Data?
You're all...
Data?
Effing useless.
You're...
Okay.
You're
Starfleet.
Admiral nice, Williams here. What can I do for you, Captain?
Oh, you know what? Hold on, Admiral Williams. Card out.
Card out.
Danub. What were you doing with them rods, Danub? What you
Chancellor,
doing with them rods, Danub?
The archaeologist Shaynock sent some artifacts to Merton Station to be tested. Can you give us any information about this?
I'm sorry. Shaynock's artifacts were in the destroyed section of the station, as were many other relics we were analyzing.
Yup.
Okay.
Thank you again for your efforts, but I'm afraid we're rather busy.
How dare you? Okay.
So it seems, it would seem...
Admiral Williams here. What can I do for you, Captain?
Yeah, Danub, I guess we don't know the story.
Yeah, he blocked our number.
Oh, what a dick.
Yeah, seriously. What a dick nub.
Anything we should be aware of?
What is the current situation?
Actually, things are relatively...
Barf. Okay. I guess that's it for now.
Picard out.
Picard out.
This is the one, one of a couple complaints I have with this game, is you kind of have
Wolf,
to just, like,
stumble into your...
Stumble into your next assignment, which I guess, if you think about it,
sorry,
is very
Captain.
True to the show,
Counselor,
but it
right.
doesn't make for
I'm
good
sorry,
gameplay.
Cap-
Computer.
Computer is always just like a database.
Astrogation, tactical,
yeah.
comms.
Captain, message from Starfleet. It is Admiral Redrick.
Okay. On screen.
Ignore that.
On screen.
ignore
fuck
her
that.
Ass.
Greetings,
oh,
Admiral.
His ass.
What can we do for you?
Jean-Luc, good to see you again. I have a little favor to ask. Would you be interested in finding a little lost lamb for me?
I mean, we are trying to do 50 things at once,
yeah.
and fight
no,
the Borg, and the Romulans, and
the
deal
list.
With the Klingon... look, sure.
Are the Klingons still a problem in Next Generation?
Not, I mean, they're a problem,
there's
but
like a
there's,
truce,
a,
right?
there's a truce.
Yeah. The Romulans, though.
The Romulans are assholes, and then eventually, the Cardassians...
Uh-huh.
Kim and the
Kim
other Kardashians.
And Chloe.
Yeah. And they ally with the Dominion.
Okay.
And then that becomes a huge war.
Uh-huh.
But, the Kardashians are literally one of the worst.
Okay, yeah.
Oh, yeah, man. Gal Dukat, the craziest Kardashian.
Uh-huh.
Once Gal Dukat got those fake boobs,
mm-hmm.
he was out of control.
Just too much.
Yeah, that's true. That was a crazy series. Deep
yeah.
Space Nine was amazing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Deep Space Nine was good.
It was really, really good.
Mm-hmm.
You know, where's the payoff?
Bring the strippers and boobs!
We do occasionally talk about video games.
Bring the strippers and boobs!
Out of the top of video games.
Bring the strippers and boobs!
Oh, thank God, I don't need pants now.
Hey, JC! What are you doing? Not much. Making a fortune.
It's a professional broadcast.
Yeah, now sing music.
It's a professional broadcast.
Bring the strippers and boobs!
It's a professional broadcast.
Now here to ask and answer one simple question.
It's a professional broadcast.
You